Hi, in this session we will go with Van der Waals equation. Van der Waals equation is applicable for real gases. The ideal gas equation is PV is equals to RT for 1 mole. Ideal gas equation. As we know, all gases are real gases. There are no ideal gases. So we need to make some adjustments in this PV is equal to RT so that we can apply this to the real gases. So the problems we are facing in kinetic molecular theory are about pressure. According to kinetic molecular theory, the pressure is because of the molecular collisions made on the walls of the container. Okay, now these are the walls. The gaseous molecules are going to collide on the walls of the container and it is going to create some pressure. And one other thing we say is there are no attractions between the gaseous molecules. Okay, now, no repulsions, no attractions, which is absolutely not correct, because if attractions are not there, a gas cannot turn into a liquid. Gases are compressible. We can convert them into liquids. So there are attractions. And when they are very close, there are definitely some repulsion forces also. Okay. So gases have attractions as well as repulsions. So now, for example, if this molecule is going to hit this wall and going to create some pressure, we are expecting this to hit this with some force better. But actually, when other molecules are surrounding this, these other molecules are going to attract this. When others are having some attractions, it cannot hit the face of the container with the same impact. The impact will be less. That means with what pressure it is to hit, that is not happening. That is all because of the other molecules attractions. So we need to add some force here. Okay, now, which is equals to A by V square. A by V square is the measure of the attractive forces that is controlling this molecule when it is going to hit. So this is the pressure that you are calculating, but more than this pressure, it is expected. So P plus A by V square. So this is the correction in the pressure. P plus A by V square is the correction in the pressure. Actually, it is creating a pressure of P, but we are expecting more than that. Okay, now P plus A by V square. Then second thing is volume. Gaseous volume is negligible. Okay, now for example, if this is the overall volume, the gaseous volume, if you consider this one, we generally say this is negligible. Okay, now, but if the volume is itself less, then the volume occupied by the gas molecules is definitely considerable. Volume occupied by the gas molecules is definitely considerable. Then in such kind of cases, the available volume for the gas molecules to move will be not V, it should be less than V, and that is given by a term B. B is, you can say, restricted volume. The volume in which the gas molecules cannot move is the restricted volume. For example, a room is there, okay, now a room is there with 10 students, let us say. Okay, now the room lead volume is 1 liter. And all the 10 students volume is, for example, 100 ml. These 10 students, they can roam in the room. Okay, now they can move in the room only in 900 ml, not in 1000 ml. Because always they are occupying 100 ml. So the available volume for them is to move is only 900 ml, not 1 liter. Okay, because always they are occupying 100 ml. The same thing is, we need to subtract the volume which is already occupied by the gas molecules and the restricted volume, you can say, that is B. Okay, now V minus B, this is the correction in the volume term. Now you can make this P plus A by V square into V minus B is equals to RT. This expression is called Van der Waals equation, but one other point is also important. That is, so I am writing here the equation P plus A by V square into V minus B is equal to RT. This is for 1 mole. P plus An square by V square into V minus NB is equal to NRT. This is for N moles. This is also known to you. Okay. There is no question about this. The thing is, they will asking you, B is equal to 4V. B is the constant B, which is equals to 4V. 4 times of the volume occupied by the gas molecules. B is equal to 4V. Remember this point. How it comes? Very simple. For example, let us say this is a molecule with a radius of R. This is another molecule with a radius of R. they can't come more than this much close. And if it is the case, then make another circle by taking the radius of 2r. This is the place where the two molecules cannot move. Okay, now this is the place where the two molecules cannot move. So this you can say the restricted volume. In this volume, the gas molecule, the both these molecules cannot move. And if you want to calculate its volume, then 4 by 3 pi r cube in place of r, that is radius and radius 2r whole cube. That means 2 cube means 8 into 4 by 3 pi r cube. This is for both the molecules. Okay, if you want to go for only with one molecule, that is half of this, that is 4 into 4 by 3 pi r cube. 4 by 3 pi r cube is nothing but the volume, that means 4 volume. For each molecule, when you compare its volume, if it is V, 4 times of its volume is not possible area, or you can say restricted volume. So B is equals to 4V. Okay, how we are doing? When two molecules are side by side, okay, now this, they can't come more close to this. So the distance, this is the radius is R and another is radius is R. With these two radius, you make one circle. This is going to be the restricted area where these two molecules cannot move. So with this, if you are calculating the volume, 4 by 3, 2R whole cube, that is nothing but 8 into 4 by 3 pi R cube. This is the restricted volume, restricted area for both the molecules. If you want to go with one, that is 4 into 4 by 3 pi R cube, that means 4V. So for each molecule, the restricted volume will be 4V. This is another important point, can be asked in entrance examination. So this is about the Van der Waals equation. Applicable for all real gases. There is no ideal gas in the universe. All gases are real gases. Real gases behave like ideal gases at high temperatures and low pressures. But if you want at any condition, you can use this one. P plus A by V square into V minus V is equals to RT for one mole. P plus AN square by V square into V minus NB is equal to NRT for N moles. Thank you.